Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and in today's vlog I will just be showing you a day in my life with my mom, who is visiting me in Miami. So if you are interested in seeing what we do, just keep on watching.
We are going to the beach. We also have to go to church today at some point, so I wanted to go earlier because I really wanted to go to an English speaking mass, because Spanish I can understand like 50-50. I have to like really focus and like really listen to the priest, so it's just so much easier when you just go to an English mass for me. But it looks like we woke up a little late today, so we're gonna have to go to a Spanish speaking mass. I don't know how my mom's gonna do, but yeah, so we're gonna go to Crandon Park today. I'm gonna show you guys what Crandon Park also looks like. Okay, so let's go.
So you guys already know that I need a big breakfast before I go to the beach for the whole day. So today we made protein pancakes and some eggs and fruit.
So this is the new bathing suit that I ended up getting yesterday, because the one I was showing you guys in my earlier vlog was way too big here. And I really like this bathing suit. It's a thong bikini, so it's perfect. I love the color. It's like a little sparkly pink. This is a really pretty bikini. I'm really happy with it. I gave her the chairs because it's so much lighter than our cooler, with like a gallon of water and all the food. We just got to Crandon Park and we're going to find a nice spot on the beach.
So in my previous vlog I went to Virginia Key, and today I wanted to show you guys Crandon Park. I love Crandon Park because of the sandbar right here. When the tide is really low, you can literally just walk out for miles on this sandbar because the water drops all the way down, so it looks like it's just a beach in the middle of the ocean. And this is one of my favorite places to come. It's very sentimental to me because this is where I shot for Maxim. Actually, this is where I would do a lot of my photo shoots, so this is how I came to find Crandon Park. Every photographer I worked with and wanted to do test shoots or magazine shoots, we would shoot them here or Virginia Key.
I'm getting off the beach real quick just to go and get some iced coffee for my mom and I. My parking is not exactly the greatest. I also parked under a tree and a bird pooped on my car. This feels so good. I'm just gonna sit in my car for like 5 minutes and just let the AC blast me in the face. It is 86 degrees outside, which is actually pretty standard for Florida, but...
So I'm gonna take you guys to Starbucks in Key Biscayne. If you don't know what Key Biscayne is, it is part of this little island where Crandon Park is located. It is located up the street from Crandon Park. And Key Biscayne is a kind of little key. It's like a little island that is divided in half by the street that we are driving on right now. So the left side of Key Biscayne is all apartments and the right side of Key Biscayne is all houses. The houses start from like $2 or $3 million and go all the way up to like 30 or 40 million. The apartments are a little bit cheaper. There is really nothing to do in this town except to get Starbucks, maybe a little bit of sushi, because it's only 5 miles away from mainland Miami. So I feel like everybody that lives here probably just goes out in Miami.
All right, you guys, so I picked up the goods and I ended up getting an iced pistachio latte. These are so good. It tastes like a liquid ice cream. It's really, really delicious. So I think you guys should try this if you like sweet and like a nutty flavor. Like, this is definitely a drink for you. I'm gonna place this on the floor and head back to the beach. I love how I still look in the back when I have cameras showing me the whole entire surrounding. I'm just so used to like looking back.
So Key Biscayne is definitely a very peaceful community. It's very family oriented. I personally have a great experience here every time I come here, but I do know some people that do complain about how snobbish the people are that live here.
This looks a little bit ridiculous. I feel like I'm out in like a wild nature beach. I mean, this looks so spoiled. We need our Starbucks. I'm the girl you would literally film and be like, oh, this girl with her Starbucks on a wild beach. And you would like poke fun of me, you know what I mean?
So now that I got my Starbucks, I was like, I'm gonna go take content pictures. So in that bag, there was walnuts and I dumped them onto a towel and put my phone into that Ziploc bag because I'm a clumsy girl. So I was afraid if I wander out into the middle of the sea with my phone, I will drop it. I brought my selfie stick and I just sat there and I was taking pictures probably for like an hour. And if you guys wanna see what they came out looking like, just follow me on Instagram. It's @MissLeannaStrama. I'll be posting them all there. So we're getting off the beach.
We are going home and we're just gonna quickly shower, get ready, go to church, and then figure out what we're gonna do for the rest of the night.
So after the beach, we showered, we put on some clothes, and we were on our merry little way to a Spanish speaking mass. My mom is not gonna understand anything the priest is saying. I actually understand a lot. I think I understood like 50% of the sermon, which is pretty impressive. I did take Spanish classes throughout college and through middle school, but you know, if you don't really practice the language, like you don't really know how to speak it, or when you understand things, it's a little bit different. So we went to that church and then we went for a walk by the water, and we were just trying to decide what we were gonna eat for dinner. My mom really wanted something fast and casual because she wanted to drive around Miami and just explore a little bit. This time when I am in Miami, it's a little bit different because I actually drove my car down here from the north, so I'm able to like drive my mom everywhere and show her everything, versus like before when we would come down to Miami, we were very limited. We had Uber and like a bike that we would rent from like City Bike. But this time around, it was so fun because anywhere she wanted to go, I would take her. So for dinner, we went to Coyo Taco, and Coyo Taco is very similar to like Chipotle, but the food is healthier and it's better. There is a location in Brickell and it's actually right next to my house, and the other location is in Wynwood. I feel like Wynwood is always super packed, so this location is definitely a better location to go and eat. There's always like a seat, and I feel like the staff is also a little nicer. But so we got burrito bowls, we got guac and chips, and we got corn, and yeah, so this was our dinner. And after dinner, we were so full that we had to go and walk it off. So it was already dark by then, so I decided to just show my mom Miami at night. And I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and subscribe and turn your post notification bell button on so you don't miss the next video. Next video is another vlog with me and my mom and a day in our lives. We were exhausted and we were heading home, and I can't believe that this girl's wearing a fur jacket in the middle of summer. I don't know how she's surviving.